I'm a software developer at Moringa, majoring in Android development. My experience has been great, and at first it was kind of challenging because I'm new to programming. This is my first time. I was able to discover my weaknesses and also my strengths. Before I joined Moringa School, I was doing a course on hydroponics farming at Mirama International College. It was a 3-month course, and after that I went into a bit of farming. I did basil farming. That's when I joined Moringa after that. I've always been a tech person, like from way back, and I just never got the right platform or the right sources to guide me to where I am today. So when I got it, I took it head on. A friend of mine referred me to it. When I first applied, I was doubtful because I thought I wouldn't get a feedback. But after that, and after all the stages, I passed successfully. And when I joined Pre-Prep, that was in February, at first it was kind of hectic because it was online. I was used to the physical learning. Because you had to gauge yourself, you also had to time yourself from like manage housework and also schoolwork. But with the support I got from my friends and family, it helped me really, really a lot. Moringa offers a very, very diverse way of learning, not like the normal face-to-face or physical learning we're used to back then. My day-to-day activity at Moringa School usually starts at around 8 in the morning, where at first we have a stand-up, a morning stand-up. It runs for 1 hour. Then after that, from 8 to 9, then after I take a break for 45 minutes, do a bit of house chores around the house, and from 10 to 12, we have sessions, we have peer sessions. We also do catch-ups at that time, also get to help one another. And from there, I take a lunch break. Then from 3 to 4, it's totally schoolwork. Then from 4, we have an evening stand-up that runs mostly up to 6. It takes 1 hour, but sometimes we extend it to 2 hours in the evening. And after that, I take a break, and a 1 hour or 30 minutes break, just to help my mind relax a bit from everything. And after that, in the evening, at 10, we also do catch-ups, peer-to-peer, get to help each other with the day's blockers and ask our peers how their day was and everything. Then I continue with learning late into the night, up until maybe 2 a.m. or 3. That's when I call it a day. Moringa do bring guest speakers, mostly on Thursdays from 5 to 6 p.m. in the evening. And a particular one, I can remember, it's Golda. She's an alumni of Moringa. And from her story, I can say that I feel highly motivated and highly prepared to whatever I expect out there after I'm done with Moringa. And since she's young, and at a young age, it's kind of challenging balancing your social life with your professional work. And since software or development, it really consumes a lot of time. So sometimes you find that your social life, it's cut off like 100%. But from my story, I can say that I found a way to balance both of them. I'd like to advise women in tech who are planning to join tech that tech, it's awesome. It's enjoyable. At first, it can be really challenging and also mind-blowing. But once you get deeper into it, you find the joy. You get to find yourself. You get to gauge yourself, your strengths and weaknesses. It's not meant for men only, and women can also take it. They should take the challenge head on. Muringa has really adapted to learning remotely ever since the outbreak of COVID-19. And since it's remotely, you as a student, you also learn at your own pace. And you also get to time yourself, maybe create a timetable. Also manage time management is really good. With Muringa, the support that we have gotten from them, most especially from the TMs, it's really, really good and really diverse. And they never left our sides because we also have a counselor. Her name is Emily. She has always been there to support us psychologically, because sometimes it can be really hectic. But from her advice and from the sessions we have with her, I can say that it has been really good, it has been great.